Lady. I am a DIY sewing enthusiast based in Lagos. Frankly speaking, the effort required to line a skirt would comfortably produce two skirts. Regardless of this, I find that lining improves the quality of the garment, it gives it volume, and allows the garment to hang properly on the frame when worn. So I'll show you the easiest way I've learned to line a skirt. So do remember to add events to the skirt. This will make movement easier. The vent should be at the bottom edge of the center back. I think I'm an obsessive pinner. I like to pin the pattern pieces down properly on the fabric so that it stays nice and secure before cutting. Make sure you double check that you've added seam allowance and hemming allowance on the pattern before cutting the fabric. So after cutting, I will end up with three pieces. A full front piece and two separate back pieces. Eventually, I'll cut out the exact same thing for the lining, which will end up being six pieces in total. I always like to start with the darts, and depending on the pattern being used, it could be a single dart pattern, therefore four darts in total, or a double dart pattern, therefore eight darts in total, or a hybrid, which could be two darts in front and four darts at the back. So make sure to press the darts nicely. This is very important so that it stays flat without any creases. The general sewing rule is that horizontal darts should be pressed down with gravity and vertical darts should be pressed towards the side of the body. I used a hybrid pattern for this skirt, so I have four darts at the back and two darts in front. So I have cut out the lining piece on the left and the shell piece on the right. An invisible zipper was also attached to the shell piece. So the lining piece and shell piece will be connected in two places, at the center back area along the zipper and also at the waist area. So I'm pinning them together right side facing because I want perfect alignment, and the first thing I'll do will be to attach them at the zipper area, that is the center back seam. So I'll connect each center back edge of the lining piece to the center back edge of the shell piece. The stitch will be as long as about 2 inches after the zipper. And once I'm done with that, I will then pin along the waistline so that it's nicely aligned, and we'll connect them about 1/4 inch along the waistline. And then finally, I'll complete the center back seam of the lining separately so that it hangs individually from the shell. The lining should be cut at least 1 inch shorter than the shell so that it doesn't peek out when worn. So an important tip to note when preparing the waistband is to attach visible interfacing to the waistband. This gives it the right volume so that it doesn't crumple when the person wearing sits down. So the first thing to do will be to attach the waistband to the skirt. I first of all pinned both right side facing, and then I will stitch along the top edge, maintaining the seam allowance provided for. Next thing would be to flip the waistband inwards and then stitch in the ditch. So it's a two-step process. So observe that I have left an extension on the left side about 1.5 inches long, which would be for either the buttonhole stand or the hook and eye. Then I'll tuck both edges inwards and then finish up the band by stitching in the ditch. I like that technique because it's very discreet. It's a very tidy finish on the outside, as no visible stitch is seen on the outside, but it's there. So I've also attached the hook and eye. I used the hand needle to sew them down. I was very keen to achieve a clean tailored finish, and so I used the blind stitches to complete the hem of the shell, so it's not visible at all. So here's the completed skirt. I was very happy with the fit. It fits beautifully. It's a beautiful skirt. Thank you for watching. I do hope you try this. You can ask any questions if you want. I'll be more than happy to answer in the comment section. Best wishes!